So here are three fundamental theorems that come out of all of this work on Nash equilibrium. They're all on the screen in front of you. I'll read them for you just in case you can't read my handwriting or if there's some typo that you discover that forces me to erase some words and then write some new ones. Okay, are you ready? All right, the first one is, in the in-player pure strategy game, if elimination of all the strictly dominated strategies eliminates all but one combination of strategies, then that combination is, in fact, the unique Nash equilibrium. So that's what happened in Prisoner's Dilemma. We got rid of all but one option, and that option had to be the unique Nash equilibrium.
You say eliminate all of them. Is it possible that things that we couldn't eliminate in one round, we could eliminate in the next round?
Yeah, it's possible. So, in fact, this is done in an iterated fashion. You get rid of whatever you can eliminate and pretend they were never there because the truth is no one would ever choose them. And then with what you have left, you just do it again. So it is possible, although not in any of the examples that we did.
Okay.
The second one is, and this both of these I think are kind of obvious. They sort of make sense anyway, at least to me, that any Nash equilibrium will survive the iterated elimination of strictly dominated strategies. In other words, if you get rid of things that are strictly dominated, you will not accidentally get rid of Nash equilibria in the process. And that makes sense because if they're strictly dominated, then if you ever end up there, you would want to leave.
And therefore can't be a Nash.
And therefore can't be a Nash equilibrium, that's right. So those two things sort of make sense, I think. The last one is true, but isn't at least painfully obvious, at least not to me, and that is if n is finite, that is you have a finite number of players, and for each of the set of strategies, that set of strategies is also finite, in other words, you're still in a finite game, then there exists at least one Nash equilibrium, which might involve mixed strategies.
So you're saying there's always a Nash equilibrium?
Yes, possibly mixed. For any finite game. So when you said I relaxed everything, I didn't actually relax the requirement that it be a finite game.
Fair enough. But you stopped writing finite, so it's sort of the same thing.
Yeah, I agree. Because why would you play an infinite game?
I don't know. Maybe you got a lot of time on your hands.
That would be like an infinite jest. Okay. So those are the main results here. So what have we learned? What we've learned is that with interesting games, we end up in these weird situations where we have to figure out how to solve the game. And one really nice concept is this notion of an equilibrium, and in particular, the notion of a Nash equilibrium.
Cool.
And there you go.